JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's weekly market outlook webinar for the week November the 8th until November the 12th. I am Charalambos, head of research here at JFD, and I will describe the most important economic releases and events on the financial agenda for the week ahead. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, we don't have any central banks deciding on interest rates this week, but we will get to hear from several policymakers, including Fed Chair Powell, ECB President Christine Lagarde, and Bank of England Governor Andrew. With regards to the data, the most important one may be the US CPIs for October, which are expected to accelerate further. And we also get Australia's employment report for the same month, for October. But let's take things from the beginning. Monday appears to be a light day in terms of economic data releases, with no major ones scheduled on the calendar. However, we will get to hear from several key central bank officials, comments of whom could affect market expectations with regards to monetary policy. Among them is Fed Chair Powell and Bank of England Governor Andrew. ECB President Christine Lagarde also speaks, but on Tuesday. Now, at last week's gathering, the Fed began its tapering process as expected, and Fed Chair Powell said that they will stay patient on interest rates. However, he did not exclude the possibility of beginning raising them soon after the tapering is over, if the economic outlook warrants so. Thus, comments suggesting that this is still the case may allow market participants to bring somewhat forth their expectations over the Fed's first rate increase, especially after the better-than-expected U.S. employment report on Friday. Now, according to the Fed Fund futures, investors are now expecting the committee to hit the hike button in September 2022. As for Bank of England Governor Bailey, we are eager to get some clarity on the coming month's wording in last week's decision statement. Remember, the Bank of England refrained from pushing the hike button, despite the majority of market participants getting convinced that this could be the case. Officials noted that this could happen over coming months, but did not give any further hints as to what coming months means. It could mean that they may not hike in December either. February is still in the coming months spectrum. The pound tumbled after last week's decision, and it could continue to do so if Bail continues to hint that they could stand pat next month as well. Last but not least, we expect ECB President Lagarde to make another attempt to push back expectations over an interest rate increase next year. Remember that at the press conference following the last decision, she noted that their analysis does not support that the conditions for a liftoff will be met at the time expected by the markets, nor any time soon thereafter. However, she failed to convince market participants, who pushed the euro up more than 100 pips against the US dollar during the press conference. Now, it will be interesting to see whether another and maybe stronger attempt will shake investors. If so, the euro is likely to turn south again, with euro dollar perhaps falling below the key support zone of 1.1524 soon. Now, on Tuesday, besides ECB President Lagarde, among other officials, we will get to hear again by Fed Chair Jerome Powell and Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey. As for the data, the only worth mentioning is Germany's ZEW survey for November. Both the current conditions and economic sentiment indices are expected to have declined somewhat to 18 and 20 from 21.6 and 22.3. This will be the sixth straight slide in the economic sentiment index and may add to concerns over how much Eurozone's growth engine has been affected by the latest bottlenecks. With such numbers, it will be hard for market participants not to listen to ECB President Lagarde and maintain their hike bets. We believe that a weak ZEW report will make her work easier and perhaps give another reason for Euro traders to sell. Now, on Wednesday, the main item on the agenda may be the US CPIs for October. Both the headline and core year-over-year rates are expected to have continued climbing higher. The headline rate is expected to hit 5.8% from 5.4%, while the core one is anticipated to have risen to 4.3% from 4%. This is likely to add to the case that the rally in inflation may eventually not be transitory and may add more credence to the view that the Fed will indeed need to start raising interest rates soon after tapering is over, especially if Fed Chair Powell keeps the door open in his Monday and Tuesday speeches. The US dollar is likely to stay on the strong side, but as far as the equity market is concerned, we don't expect any potential setback to be long-lasting. We believe that if data continue to suggest that the US economy has fared better than many may have expected in the midst of supply shortages, equities will continue cheering the economic resilience despite the likelihood of more aggressive tightening by the Fed. After all, equity investors may have already digested the idea of higher rates in the not too distant future. Now, as for the rest of Wednesday's data, ahead of the US CPIs during the Asian session, we get inflation data from China as well. The CPI rate is forecast to have risen to 1.4% year-over-year from 0.7%, while the PPI is anticipated to have accelerated to 12.4% year-over-year from 10.7%. Now, on Thursday, during the Asian session, Australia releases its employment report for October. The unemployment rate is expected to have risen to 4.8% from 4.6%, while the net change in employment is forecast to show that the economy has added 50,000 jobs after losing 138,000 in September. In our view, a 50,000 jobs gain is not encouraging news if we take into account that apart from the 138,000 loss in September, the Australian economy lost even more jobs in August, around 146,000. Thus, combined with a potential increase in the unemployment rate, we would expect market participants to push further back their expectations with regards to a rate increase by the RBA and perhaps push the Aussie lower. Remember that last week, the RBA appeared more hawkish than previously, saying that it could start raising interest rates in 2023 instead of 2024, according to its previous guidance. However, market participants were even more hawkish, anticipating a hike around the middle of next year and seeing rates hitting 1.25% by the end of the year. Thus, the RBA's view was seen as a disappointment, and a soft employment report, could add more credence to it. Later in the day, we get the preliminary UK GDP for the third quarter, alongside the nation's industrial and manufacturing production rates for September. Economic activity is expected to have slowed to 1.5% quarter over quarter from 5.5%, while both the industrial and manufacturing production rates are anticipated to have slid to 0.1% month over month from 0.8% and 0.5% respectively. In our view, such numbers would add credence to the Bank of England's choice of staying sidelined last week and may increase speculation that the rate hike may eventually be delivered in the first months of the new year instead of in December. This is likely to encourage some more pound selling. The UK trade balance for the month is also coming out. Now, finally, on Friday, the only noteworthy releases on the agenda are the US JOLTS job openings for September and the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for November. The JOLTS openings are expected to have increased somewhat, while the University of Michigan Index is anticipated to have inched up to 72.5 from 71.7. So, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. I hope you have a great week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next Monday. If you are interested in more detailed and frequent analysis, you can find me on our YouTube channel from Tuesday to Friday at around 9 a.m. GMT. So goodbye, have a nice day, and a better week.
JFT, just fair and direct.